Adelaide rail commuters are being told to expect delays to their daily commute when the system is closed down and replaced with buses early next year. Reporter Jessica Braithwaite has the latest on the rail closures.
Yes, Beck, well, I'm here at the Adelaide Railway Station and it has been quite busy this afternoon, but commuters had better make the most of it because come January, this whole place will be shut down. A lot of the outer lines are going to be closed down too, some for as long as 9 months. And of course, you don't close down almost an entire rail network without causing some inconvenience. And today, we've had a first look at just how the government plans to make all of this work. No matter where you live or where you're headed, come January, you're going to be forced off track. Alternative bus routes released today for the Norlunga and Tonsley rail lines, which will be closed until September for upgrades. The Belair line, closed down until mid-next year, will also be serviced by buses. But there's a catch. Those bus services won't necessarily follow the advertised routes. If the bus is full, passengers will need to raise their hand to alert the driver they want to get off at a stop before the city. If they fail to do so, the bus becomes an express service.
We'll get it into the city on the quickest way possible.
Commuters left waiting along the original route will need to wait for the next available bus, a system already confusing some.
Just putting your hand up, that's not really, you know, enough communication to the bus driver.
Very confusing for some people, I reckon.
It would be awkward because having my headphones on, I'd be listening to my music and I wouldn't be paying attention, and obviously, like, I wouldn't hear the driver talking.
Throughout January, the Gawler and Outer Harbour lines will terminate on the city fringes, and substitute buses will ferry passengers the rest of the way. Disrupted commuters offered a free month of travel as a sweetener.
We set out in 2008 to revitalise our rail system. I can't revitalise, we can't do it without rebuilding the track.
The Transport Department insists there is light at the end of the tunnel.
Return services that will be improved, will be smoother, will be more reliable.
Now, the Transport Department says it will have staff on the ground at those stations helping people get onto the right buses, and those timetables will be available online from Monday. Beck.
Thank you, Jessica.